Hi everyone, I'm Soumya Sharma and I've secured rank 9 this year. This was my first attempt. I graduated only last year from National Law University, Delhi, and my optional was also law. So I know it sounds very breezy to hear that first attempt and such a good rank, but I want to tell you that the journey is very difficult and it requires a lot of hard work from your side. So please keep that in mind. If you are preparing for this examination, you should know that hard work is extremely important. And you will have to push yourself, you will have to push your boundaries, and you have to do that. And I will, before I begin my strategy for the papers, I would just briefly like to tell you about my story, because I really hope it motivates you and it inspires you to not give up, because I believe I had a very different story when it comes to giving this examination. So when I was 16 years of age, I lost my hearing. And I've been using hearing aids to talk and to converse. So that was a very big setback for me at that point of time. And because all through my life, 15 years, I was perfectly fine. And to suddenly get that setback, it was very difficult. But I would just tell you, like, no matter what life throws at you, just pick yourself up and move on. So I was lucky to have cleared this in the first attempt, but you may have to give multiple attempts to get a good rank or whichever way. But no matter what happens, just don't lose faith in yourself, because that's the first step. You really cannot convince someone else that, you know, you can do it unless you have convinced yourself. So that is the most important. And you have to have a very positive outlook towards this preparation to do this. The second episode which happened with me, which I think made it very sad at that point of time, was that during the mains examination, I was sick with viral fever. So the day of the essay was on Saturday. I slept for barely 3 hours in the night because the fever was catching up. I just went, wrote the essay. When I came back home, I had a fever. It started progressing. I'm lucky to have doctors for parents. Both my parents are doctors. So Sunday, which was the day before the GS papers were on Monday and Tuesday, I spent the entire day on my bed. I couldn't do any revisions. I had planned a lot of short notes, short revisions. I couldn't do anything. I was getting intravenous drips injected. It was extremely terrible, and I was thinking, what is going on? I even have this mark on my hand from the drips. It still hasn't gone away. It was a very difficult experience. Like, why is it happening? But somehow, I just went to write the exams, couldn't revise properly. Really difficult to write it. Somehow wrote it, and I'm lucky and very glad and very grateful that it worked in my favor. But my point is that even if any situation comes and you feel that all your hard work is coming to a naught, whatever you have done may not amount to anything, just don't give up. Try. What if, you know, you never know. It's better to try and know what happened than to never try at all. So just try, don't lose faith in yourself. That's extremely important, because at least if you go down, you'll go down with the knowledge that I put in my best, and that's very important. So that is about my story, and I'm sharing this with you because last year I was also sitting at home watching Topper Talk videos and used to get very inspired that, you know, this is so amazing. I really hope you are also inspired just like I was by previous year toppers. So this was that. Now I'll talk about my strategy, my preparation strategy. I formally started preparing in February 2017, 19th February, I remember the exact date, and my interview happened on 19th Feb 2018. So it was a 1 year cycle for me. But I have to tell you, I will not gloss over that this 1 year I was just studying. I didn't do anything else, I was just studying, and you have to do that. Because think of it. The way I used to think of it was that if I put in some effort right now, I might be able to serve my country in a good way. And that is the motivation which should drive you. And this motivation should come from within. It's very important. Don't lose focus of the target. Don't lose focus of why you're doing this. And if your prime motivation is honest and genuine, you should be able to keep yourself motivated. So I didn't start from scratch. I believe I had a good base because I had read certain books previously. My graduation in law helped me with the polity part of the prelims examination. So I do believe I was lucky in that aspect. But so February onwards, the way I started was, I took subject-wise. I did not study multiple subjects at a time. I had targets of subjects. If I'm doing polity, I'll finish the Lakshmikant book. Only then I'll move on to history. That is how I did it. Because if you take one subject at a time and if you master that subject, it's always better. And you are sure that what I've done is, you know, the best I could do. So first I started by finishing all the standard books. All the toppers talk about them. You must know what the standard sources are. I don't need to talk about them. So first I read all the standard books, made notes wherever necessary. For books like Lakshmikant, you don't need to make notes. You just have to read the text. It's very important. And even if you look at last year's prelim examination, the kind of questions that have been asked, they require a level of analytical understanding. So just read the books, read the text thoroughly. That is about prelims. Take some good test series. I joined I used to solve some of the vision tests and I had joined Insights. So join any good test series and practice, because that is most important. You'll know how to time yourself, you'll know how to give the examination in the exam hall. So in a controlled environment, you need to practice the test. CSAT, please don't take it lightly. Many people get very high marks in the first paper, but they fail to clear CSAT. So what I did, I wasn't keen on doing CSAT. My father was after me that you have to start solving. So there are some books which come for SSC and Bank PO examinations. They also cover CSAT and they cover it in a comparatively easy way. So if you are having problems, you can refer to those books, but definitely take out some time to sharpen your CSAT skills, okay? This is about prelims. And also don't get disheartened by the marks that you are scoring in your prelims examination in the mock test, because everyone scores low marks, but gradually over time you'll know how to practice it better. Like I started, when I started giving my tests, I was scoring like 70-80. The last few tests, mock tests that I wrote, I was scoring some 130 or so. So you will see the improvement in your own self. You just have to keep on practicing. So this was about prelims. Now I'll talk about newspaper reading and note making before I move on to the GS strategy. See, newspaper reading is extremely, extremely important for this paper, and I'll tell you why. Because if you are studying just to clear prelim, it may affect your preparation in the mains examination. And we have to, when we start studying, I'm sure all of you must be thinking, we'll go and we'll write the, we'll give the interview, we'll get a rank, right? Nobody thinks ki prelims clear ho jaye bas, right? So you have to, your preparation from the very beginning should be chiseled in a way that it is preparing you to write your mains and your interview, okay? So for that, newspaper reading is extremely important. So the way I did it was, before prelims, I was reading the Hindu every day. And the Hindu, the way I used to read it was, so there is something called speed reading. Okay, I think I am very fast at reading. I'll tell you how to do it. So if you're reading a newspaper article, you don't have to read word by word, line by line. Skim through it. Train yourself. It will take some time. Do some fast reading. Skim through the article. If you see something worthwhile, something of information, stop. Read it properly. Read it again. Okay, and this will save your time. So this is something which you'll have to practice, fast reading and stopping when you see something, rather than reading every word, every line of the article properly. And that will come with practice, okay? So you have to read one newspaper before prelims, because the kind of questions they ask in prelims are very specific, and they're more than the questions, the MCQ choices are very confusing. So you need to have one monthly magazine. I used to read the Vision monthly magazine and the Vision 365 for government schemes. They're both very important. You need to revise them multiple times over and over again. That will be very helpful. So after prelims, for mains, my strategy was, I was reading two newspapers every day, the Hindu and the Indian Express. The reason being, okay, the news definitely is repeated, but the editorials are very good. And if you look at it, most of you, I've been getting some messages that, how do we learn to critically analyze? How do we get that own, our own thinking, how do we have our own opinion? That will come only if you read editorials. And I'll tell you how. Only yesterday or day before, there was this article in the Indian Express on Karl Marx. Someone has criticized Karl Marx. If you read that article, one is you read it, okay? The other is you read it, you think about it. Do you agree with what the person is saying? Do you have something different? Do you have a different opinion? That is the critical thinking, that is it. Critical thinking is nothing but using your own thinking to make your own opinion on a particular point. And that will come only if you read good opinion pieces. And that you find in the Hindu and the Indian Express. So the way I used to go about it was, I had four registers. This was after prelims. I had four registers, GS 1, 2, 3, 4, in which I used to make notes of newspaper articles. And I did not obviously write the whole article again, but like I was telling you, the basic points, the basic premise of that article, and short condensed notes, which I could revise multiple times. And trust me, that helped a lot. Because mains is usually about current affairs, but having good points from the newspaper, having a good opinion definitely helps. And I, although the marks haven't been released yet, I do think my GS papers have helped me achieve this rank today. So you have to do, you could do something like that. And apart from that, for certain topics about note making. So there are certain topics such as international relations, which are very dynamic. They continue to evolve every day. So for that, the way I used to do was, I used to make sheet notes, like take loose sheets, A4 size sheets. So India, US, it's one page. Now, whatever is happening in the India-US dynamics, keep on adding. You'll start in July. By October, you'll have a lot of fodder for your answers, okay? So for topics which are constantly evolving, it's better to like stick to loose pages and keep on adding on to them. Now, so for the GS papers, current affairs is not everything, okay? Although newspaper reading is very important, and like I told you, newspaper reading is important to have your own opinion, which was extremely important, but it is not all. What you need to do is the static part of the syllabus needs to be known, okay? Like this time there was a question in GS3 on nuclear power plants. That was not in the news anywhere, but that's static part of the syllabus. So the way to be, it's to be done is first of all, finish the static part of the syllabus. So you have the syllabus with you. The syllabus, you should all memorize it by heart, okay? Not learn it, but you should know what the syllabus is. Take each topic. This is what I did. Google every topic, every topic. You'll know the whole expanse of the topic. You'll know the breadth of, and the depth of the topic. You'll know what all you could expect from that topic, okay? For instance, when you read the topic on GS3 science and tech, you can expect something on India's nuclear power plant. Okay, this is something which will come by brainstorming, and this is something you have to do. So all the topics, GS 1, 2, 3, 4, Google them, have good books with you. Internal security also. Things like this, there are books available in the market. Start reading. You should have the static part ready, because in your answers, if you demonstrate in your answers that you know this topic, and how will you demonstrate? By showing them that you are aware of the static also, you just don't know about the current. And that will happen only if you know this static part well. So that is one. I'll give an instance. For instance, the Right to Persons with Disabilities Act came last year. So the way my notes on that were made, so a lot of editorials were coming in the newspaper on that act. The way the notes had to be made is, firstly, I mean, give the heading, right to rights of persons with disabilities. This is the heading. What happened before? There was another act in 1995, okay? Then a new act came. Why did this new act come? What were the recent developments which happened, which prompted the coming of this act? All these things, a topic has to be covered comprehensively. Because they will not ask you, tell us about the act. They are going to ask you something more nuanced, like why this act, what were the problems, what are the problems still with this act. So cover a topic comprehensively. Think, you have to think. There's no other way. Don't expect someone to spoon feed you, please. Like, you have to think yourself what all could be asked. What all are the dimensions of this topic? For instance, many times, Indian Express has some really good, so there's this page which comes called Explained page. It has very informative articles. If you're reading that, you will sometimes feel that, okay, I think this article doesn't really address this issue well. So just use your internet, Google that. So you have to think yourself on how much of a topic is, you know, based. You have to do that. So this was that. Then I will come to writing the test series. So the first test that I wrote here in Vision, I just came. I didn't revise anything. I just came to write the test. And it was a GS2 test. I scored some 70 marks or so. I didn't perform very well. But the point is, I later on realized that whatever tests you are writing, you have to revise for them. You have to do them very thoroughly. Revise the topics, because this test series is a very good way of actually practicing the way you will be performing in the final exam. So be very serious with the test series, because there's one thing. One thing is I'm sitting at home, I'm reading everything, I think I know it. But there's another thing coming here, sitting in the midst of other candidates, writing that exam, then you finally realize, okay, you know, this is where I'm bad at and this is where I need improvements in. Which leads me to another thing, your strategy should suit you. It should suit your own weaknesses and strengths. And that is something you have to think of yourself. For instance, when I was preparing for this exam, I thought for mains, I'm good with geography and history. Like these were my favorite subjects in school. GS2 was something I've studied in law. Most of it was covered. So my strategy was that GS1, 2 is something I'm going to focus on. Essay is something is very, very scoring. As the previous speaker very nicely explained, do not take essay lightly. You can score a lot of marks in the essay. If you think you can write well, if you think you could do it, please focus a lot on your essay. Okay? So this is for general studies, but at the same time, I know most of you rely on the optional, but again, do not practice only your optional. Do not try to specialize only in your optional, because you have to score equally well in both the optional and the GS papers for a good rank. Because you have to divide your time, and that is something which comes with only practice and proper time management. All right. So even in the test series, I'll tell you how I wrote my answers, and this is what I did during my mains also. I used to fill all the pages, because first of all, I write very broadly. I have a very big handwriting, so that would help me fill the pages, and also it looks good. It shows that, you know things. So if the thing with GS is, so if the question is asking critically analyze, like there was a huge discussion on this before, you should critically analyze, but at the same time, what you have to do is you have to demonstrate to the examiner that you know about this topic. That is the whole test. What is the test? The test is of general studies. You just have to show them that you're a generally aware person, you know what is being asked, and you know what the question is asking, and you can answer the question well. And that will come only if you're right. And that will come only with practice, only with preparation. I'll come to the sources. And also another thing, I did not make any diagrams, any flowcharts in my answers, because like I told you, I was extremely sick. All the diagrams which I had to revise, I couldn't revise them. So I just wrote. And when it comes to points or paragraphs, it was to depend, answer to answer based. But you could do any way, either way. Start with a paragraph, then divided into points, then again para points. Anyway, that you know, when you are sitting in the exam hall, you will yourself know the way to write it. Okay, and also please focus on the qualifying language papers. I know some people who couldn't clear the Hindi paper, which comes in that. So you have to focus and divide your time equally amongst all. But at the same time, you should focus on your strengths and try to improve your weaknesses, because you will be preparing with this mindset, ki acha, you know, let me finish this one because I'm very good at this. But what if they ask the thing you're not good at in the paper? So you have to think the best case scenario as well as the worst case scenario and prepare accordingly. And also there's this show, The Big Picture, which comes on Rajya Sabha TV. You should watch it. I used to watch it while eating my food. It's very good and relaxing, because the way you see different people with different perspectives, it also helps you to channel your opinions and make your own opinions and things. Now, I'll briefly talk about the essay preparation. So, essay, the way I did it was, I wanted to show to the examiner or the person reading the essay that it's like a human being to human being interaction. There should be some element of emotions in your essay too. I'm not saying write a very emotional letter there, no. All I'm saying is that the person reading it should be able to gauge the kind of person you are by reading your essay. I'll give you a very brief example, which I remember now. So the two essays, so section A, section B. Section A is usually factual, section B is usually abstract. So in section A, I wrote about agriculture, but while writing on agriculture, I emphasized again and again how farmers are important. I emphasized on how, I wrote this one sentence, I remember now, that from the president of a country to a poor laborer, all require farmers and farmers' hard work. And this is why farmers are important. So any topic that you're writing, think of the bigger picture. Think of the broader picture. Try to establish connect with the person who's checking your essay. And this doesn't have to be overdone. Definitely not. Your essay should read like it's been written by a bureaucrat or to be bureaucrat. It has to be backed with facts, If you have data, then very good, write the data. Your GS preparation will definitely help you with the essay. So write all of that, but at the same time, do not lose focus of the fact that it's an essay. An essay is the one paper where you can truly show them who you are and how you think. So any format can be used for the essay, or like past, present, future, or the social, political, economic. But whichever way you're doing it, is the one thing which is very important is that it should have a flow. And it should flow well. What I did, I was having certain problems with the flow thing, so I arranged for an expert session here because I had joined the Vision Essay Test series. So make use of your resources and try to have such sessions and find where you're doing wrong, because essay is truly one paper which can give you a good rank. So, and also, when it comes to choosing the topic of the essay, this is something very important. Don't think that everybody else is writing on this, so I shouldn't do this. Doesn't matter what everybody else is doing. If you think you're good at this topic, then do that topic. Because for the examiner, you might think I'm doing a very good thing by writing this less chosen topic. But for the examiner, it may be a very average topic. So it doesn't matter. You have to choose a topic which you are most comfortable with writing and in which you can fully express yourself well. So I wrote on agriculture, and in this abstract part, I wrote on the woman, the myth of a new and the new woman in India as it is a myth. So because these are two topics, I thought I can write very comfortably in. Yeah. So this was about the essay. Now I'll briefly come to preparation for GS papers, which is very important. So for the current affairs, like I told you, Hindu, Indian Express, and the big picture, Rajya Sabha TV, Yojana magazine, very important. Kurukshetra also, you could read. I think there was some horticulture issue in Kurukshetra magazine, and horticulture was asked last year. So you should focus on these magazines, which everybody reads. Then you could also refer to some website sources, like I was following Insights on India very regularly, and Mrunal. Mrunal.com also has some very good articles on your preparation. So you could follow these sources. For the static part of the GS papers, I've written them down for you guys. So, world history, the vision document is extremely good. You don't need to cover anything else. If you read the vision document properly again and again, you can answer questions. Like this time, the world history question was something on the Malay Peninsula and the colonization problems that were faced. If you read the document properly, you could write something based on your knowledge, okay? Then, history geography will be NCRTs. I followed the old NCRT by R.S. Sharma for ancient history and the current NCRTs. Geography goes along and 11th class NCRT is super important. Then, for the modern history part, I did not read the thick book by Bipin Chandra because I did not have the time. I started preparing in Feb. But what I did was, there's one book by Bipin Chandra, the old history book by Bipin Chandra. So it's also a very informative, very good book, that plus spectrum, this will do. Then for art and culture, I read CCRT, it's very good, very informative. NIOS, the National Institute of Open Schooling, and there's an art book of 11th class NCRT, these are good. And so art and culture, even if you're reading history, ancient history, focus on the chapters that talk about how people used to live there. The culture of the civilizations, that's more important than which king came after which king, okay? Then climate change and associated topics, you could refer to the internet for that. Follow any good articles on it. Locational factors, again, I was referring to Mrinal.com. It has very good articles on it. For GS2, the ARC reports, they are super important. Not just for GS2, but also for ethics. If you go through the reports, you will see, you can correlate topics that they are very, very important, and you should definitely read them because you have to maximize your score in the GS papers. Lakshmikanth has there some selected chapters from DD Basu, which I did because I also had law optional. If you want to do, you can't, but since I had law optional, I also read that. Then there are some vision documents on selected topics. You could read them, such as separation of powers and such topics. You could read those documents. International relations, I already told you, make sheets, loose sheets, keep on adding on to these topics because these are really dynamic topics, and it's always better to have all your information in one particular place. And I used to make handwritten notes for this because you have to write in the mains examination. So any way you prefer, but I preferred handwritten notes. For GS3, very important, and economy, take any one good book and you can just read that for basic concepts and then add on with your current affairs. Agriculture also, if you read agriculture, comprises of, I think, some 4 or 5 topic points in the GST syllabus. So it's a very important topic. You could write it in your essay also. So refer to some good material for agriculture. And disaster management, it's not enough material is available. I was lucky enough to have some good guidance on this. But what you could do is go to the website of the NDMA, the Disaster Management Authority. There are some reports that they have published on how to tackle different disasters. You will know everything on urban floods, cyclones, everything is there. So it's always good to go to original sources, the primary sources. A report given by the NDMA is more authoritative than some notes by some other person. So refer to primary sources and make your own notes out of that, because it will also be easier for you to do it that way. Internal security, again, many books are available. I would suggest you to read them because it's a very big topic and it's also very important. For GS4, anyone, so it's available in the market here, any one source, plus you could read this book, It's The Difficulty of Being Good by Guru Charan Das. I had read it earlier. It's very good. If you have time, you could read it now. And also for the people who are in college or who have a lot of time before they give their attempt, there are 3 books which I would refer. One is This Difficulty of Being Good. It's just a very good book. You can just read it just like that. Then there is one, The Land of 7 Seas. It's by, I don't remember the name of the author right now. I forgot to write it. But it's a very good book. It combines the geography and the history of India. It's very informative. It's like a novel. You'll really enjoy reading it. It's a very thin book. It will help you make a base for your history and geography. And the third book is India After Gandhi by Ramchandra Guha. You could read these books if you have a lot of time on your hands. If the exam, if you're writing this year, please don't read them. These are for people who have a lot of time with them. So yeah, this was about my strategy, and I hope I was able to help you. I'll just briefly talk about the interview preparation also. For interview, your DAF, very important to read, and current affairs, cover all these topics. Before the interview, I started reading Times of India as well, because it covers the daily news of my own city, and such kind of news is important for interview. But I would tell you, please do not rely on optional marks, interview marks, or GS marks alone, because you can never say, okay, you can never say which will be scoring for you or which won't. You have to divide your time equally, give respect to all papers, and you have to be genuine with your preparation. Remain honest with yourself. Whatever targets you are setting, finish them, and be true to your goal is the most important thing. Have a good intention behind your preparation, and always remember, it's very easy now to think, I studied for 1 year, ho gaya, but I know how difficult that 1 year was. And it should be, it definitely should be difficult for you, because it makes the success better if you know you've worked hard for it. So you have to work hard, keep on pushing yourself, but at the same time take breaks. And but I did not have any one schedule to my day, but my schedule revolved around my studies. Whatever I was doing, studies were the main thing, and other things were just subsidiary to that. So that's all, and thank you. And if you have any questions, you could ask me. That will come only via revision. You have to keep on revising again and again. I know things like geography, history are difficult to memorize, but you have to memorize them just by revision. It depends, whichever way you like. If you prefer, you can make your own notes out of these books. Huh? But you have to revise. There's no other way. And if there are certain topics which you are specifically having problems with, you can watch a few videos of the same. Many videos are available. Like, I remember, so there is this meandering rivers topic and oxbow lakes and all of that, and backward erosion. So for that, I watched many videos online, because it was a very dynamic topic, the way it's happening. So just watch videos if you think you are getting stuck with one topic, but you need to revise to remember. There's no other way. Okay, yeah. See, so for everyone, every topic, there will be one aspect of it which will dominate. But people say like the legal aspect dominates, okay? Some topics, the economic aspect will dominate. But what you have to remember is you're writing the answer for general studies. And also you should keep in mind if it's a GS2 answer, GS1 answer. For instance, I'll just give the example of triple talaq. If triple talaq is asked in GS1, you should give a sociological perspective to it. If it's given in GS2, it should be something to do, focus more on the legal aspects of it. So you have to keep in mind what paper you are writing and about which points to cover. Because every one of us will have some specialization, like I had law and you also have a similar background. This is why I'm talking, you have to read newspapers because newspapers will be repeating those points which are very relevant. And newspaper reading will help you separate the brain from the shaft. You'll know this is more important. And the same points will be repeated in different newspapers, different editorials, and those are the points which you should mention. So time management also has to be done in a similar way. You have to focus on the points which are very relevant, but at the same time, don't get too excited if you know a particular topic well. Remember, there are 19 more questions to write, and remember that what the question is asking. For instance, if you read triple talaq, you had made really good notes on triple talaq, you don't have to write everything there. Read the demand of the question, and for that, there is a sheet in the Vision IAS portal for, which tells you about the keywords, critically analyze, explain, what do all these mean. Keep that with you. Answer the question, don't tell the examiner what you know. That's the difference. I got it. So what I did not mean go to Google and no more. What I meant was, so for instance, let's talk about panchayats, okay? For instance, you have a particular information source in panchayats and you are relying on that. What I mean is, so recently there was a judgment in which the court held that people who do not have a school degree, they cannot contest panchayat raj elections. That is something which is current affairs. If you are reading on panchayat, you would not know of it until you know the latest news on it, right? So what I meant was, the whole point of Googling the topics is to know any recent developments, to know, so for instance, nanotechnology, robotics, it says in GS3. I read the Wikipedia pages of these two to know what exactly is there, because my strategy was that I have to do it this time. And if the syllabus says one word, you should know what is behind this word. I know what nanotech is, but do you actually know what it is? Do you know what it entails, when it began and all of that? That was my intention behind saying that. That you should know how much of the topic evolves. And about UPSC, again, you have to make your own judgment. Definitely, you do not have to go into the level of specialization, but if there's something which you think you should be generally aware about, you should know about it. That was the intention. Because certain topics often get ignored. If some books are not covering it, some notes are not covering it, so many of the topics, we ignore it. That was my intention. So the topics have certain words written. You should know the expanse behind that. So The intention was to ensure you know the syllabus. No. Okay. So about 16 to 17 hours, the thing is, start at 8 hours, okay? Then the thing with me is, the reason I studied for such long hours was I knew it, that I have very little time. I started preparing in Feb. The prelims was in 18 June. My final examination of law was in 2nd June. I knew I'm extremely tight on time, so I had no other way. I would suggest you, if you have a lot of time, you don't have to put in those many hours. I was constrained to do that because of the lack of time with me. Whatever suits you, make your own strategy. This is what I'm saying, your strategy should suit you. Like, I'm the kind of person, like, and I did all self-study, I did not take any coaching. I can sit at one place and study for long hours. So that was me, and that is why I was able to do it. Also, after my college ended, I was staying at my home, and most of my needs were taken care of. I did not have to get up and take care of things like food and all that. I was again very lucky to have that. So, which is I was able to. If you can't, please don't. Don't. Also, another thing, for anyone who is writing the exam, let's say next year, don't overexert yourself. Don't study so much right now that when you actually have to go and write your mains or before your mains, you are so exhausted that you can't do it. Okay? You cannot let your brain get exhausted. Start slow, be gradual, and slowly you can increase the number of hours that you're putting in. Come on. So what I used to do was I used to listen to music. I love listening to music. I used to listen to some Punjabi music. It used to give me some energy. Do anything which you feel like it. I used to talk to one of my friends on the phone. Anything which drives you, anything which motivates you. But very honest advice, please do not start watching TV series. That will never stop. You will just start binge watching, and the next thing you know, you'll spend 10 hours watching a TV series. So anything which is short, like watch TED Talks on YouTube, they're very motivational. Watch Topper Talks, I used to do it. Every time I used to feel like what is going to happen and what am I doing, I would just watch some nice talks by toppers on such forums. So find what drives you and do that. You have been asking. I can't hear you properly. Could you just speak a little louder? So, first of all, internships. So about internships, I did many internships. After every semester, I was interning. And the reason being, you are a law student, and this is a wonderful opportunity which only law school offers. So why not take it? It will definitely help. Like, I interned with HRLN. I got human rights exposure. I interned with PRS Legislative. That was also a good exposure. So definitely do internships, okay? That will help. Although about the interview, can't say. I wrote them in my DAP as work experience, but you could do that. But again, see, interview is a very short process of the examination, which carries a lot of marks. You cannot just rely on the interview for your rank. You have to focus on your mains. But it can definitely help. It shows that you have prior experience and you are just not a fresh graduate, that one. About the second law option preparation, I couldn't do it here because others are here. But I'm going to write a proper blog on my personal blog on law option preparation. But similar, and what you could do for law option right now is start following legal developments which are happening, such as Live Law, The Wire. These websites have very good law coverage, so that. Rest the basic sources remain the same. I couldn't go into it because it will get very lengthy. About essay and research papers, definitely not. Research papers in law are very specific, footnotes and all, and proper research. Your essay has to, you do not have to come across as a scholar in your essay. You have to come across as a future bureaucrat, a person who has answers to solutions plaguing this country. So it has to be broad. Research paper koi relation nahi hai. Your essay has to be very, very broad, and you have to cover as many points, and you have to figure out the problems, give solutions, and end it on a very positive note. So they are not similar. I can't hear you. Sorry? So prelims test series. I joined Insight and I used to solve certain tests of vision. So vision tests, like the, if I felt like I am not very good with economics because I had no prior learning of economics. So certain topics, but stick to one thing. Don't try to do everything, because especially if you have less time. But for prelims test series, the most important thing, more than solving them, is to read the solutions. Read the solutions well, and wherever you feel that you have missed something or you are not able to understand it, Google it. Try to understand it. That is most important. Yeah. See, again, for that, this is why static plus current. If you have Karl Marx is something we all read in GS paper 1 as different ideologies and all, that's important. So the reason I'm not talking specifically on Marx, that was just an example. It could be any article. What I tried to say was that if you're reading something, you could have different responses to the article that you have read. One is you totally agree with the person, which is great, okay? Second is you think, okay, I may think a little differently. The point is just cultivate your own thinking. And definitely you need to, which is I am repeating it, that you should know, read reports, read original sources to know facts. Your arguments in the GS answer should be based in facts, okay? And this is how you can make your own opinions that you, because you know facts. So that depends on the question. What you are going to write there does not depend on your prior thoughts, that it will depend on what the question is asking. The whole point of giving that example was to cultivate your own thinking, which is going to help you write the answer, and that you will know only when you see the question. The question will demand certain thing out of you, and you have to answer that. That is the whole point of the answer. So this is just an example. Like anything you are reading, this is the whole point. So in this preparation, even if you're talking amongst your peers, if someone is saying something, instead of just agreeing with them, try to disagree. Try to have your own opinion on it, and that will give you the critical thinking required for this exam. You have answered. Writing two test series depends on your time. Okay, what I was doing was I was solving one test series very diligently in a controlled environment. Like phone is switched off and nobody is disturbing me for those 2 hours. That you should definitely do for one. If you think you haven't been able to, you know, build up your own confidence by one, then go to the second. But what I would suggest, what I did also, is was not to start solving them. The second one, if you think, for instance, vision has a topic-wise test series. So if you think economy is something you're not very comfortable with, read the solutions. Read the answer, read the solution. That is better, because you'll know the answer to it, you'll understand a new topic. So, and also solving two test series may take up a lot of time. So manage your time well. About sociology, in law school, we had studied socio as a subject. So I had prior understanding of it, but I have read about this. There is a class 12th NCERT book on socio. So very basic concepts are explained very well in that. If you someone has a problem with understanding socio, instead of buying a book by some other person, just buy that NCERT class 12th. Definitely. So I forgot to mention it. I have been reading newspapers from a very young age because my mother used to read newspapers and I used to sit with her. I got into this habit. I picked up my alphabets from the newspapers and all. And this was the Times of India, which is a very catchy newspaper. So it just attracts you to it for some reason. It's not like the Hindu or Indian Express. They're a little academic. Definitely that did play a role. The prior experience of getting to read newspapers and my whole performance record during school and everything, definitely it helped. For someone who is beginning newspapers, I would suggest if you have a lot of time on your hands, start by reading some regular newspaper so that you get into the habit. Because getting into the habit is the most difficult part, because if you are starting by reading the Hindu all of a sudden and you have no prior experience with newspaper reading, it may be difficult. So if you have a lot of time, start like give 2 weeks by reading some other newspaper, cultivate a habit and then move on to the other newspapers. This only, skim reading. See, you have to skip political news, okay? You have to skip the sports page. These are the things you will just skip. Some city-based news, like some murders are being reported, things you have to skip. You have to know the syllabus by heart. And when you are reading a newspaper, try to find, does this correlate with that? And even within those articles, do skim reading. Read fast if you think. See, again, that depends on the demand of the question. You will know. If the question is specifically asking for your own opinion, it's always better to give a brief intro on what you think. But it all depends on the question, and that is something which you learn only when you write answers and practice it. You joined late, I think. So it depends. Like start with the para, move on to point, or just make it point-based. That is also something which you can just alternate between answers. There's no, it depends on how you are comfortable with expressing yourself. So in my college, in the last semester, we had classes only for 1.5 hours in the morning. Most of the heavy duties topics were covered in the previous years. Fifth year for me and the last semester when I started preparing was very chill. So I was able to do it. I used to go to class in the morning, come back by 10:30 in my hostel. Hostel is just in the same building and I used to study. So because of that, it was easy. And research papers is something which took some time to submit, but just took out time and did it. See, if you have 2 years, read these books, make a base, and but don't overexert yourself, Abhi. It will be too early. Depends. If you think you're good with reading the NCERTs only, then just read them. If you think you're more comfortable with notes, make notes. There are many people, many toppers who do not make notes. I like making notes, so I made my own notes. It depends on you. Yeah, you are asking. Why did I start a bit early? Yeah, good that you asked. So I, in college, I had many seniors who are now in the IAS, and I was inspired by them. But something happened, something on a personal level, I thought I don't want to do the civil services examination. I was placed, I had my job with me, so I was like, I'll just do it. Something very, I wrote, it's something personal, it happened at home. It was a Sunday, 19 Feb, and I was at home. Something happened at home, which evening me, my mother told me, and I said, okay, mom, I'm going to write. And at that point of time, it was, and I remember the notification came out on 22nd of Feb, 3 days before I decided, and it was very spur of the moment, and the way 19 Feb to 19 Feb this year, I think I've been just very, very lucky also, I would say, to have it. You could underline, but don't do highlighters and stuff like that. If you think it depends. If you are writing something and you think you are mentioning a report, which if you know something like in the name of a report, underline it. But don't underline everything. अच्छा एट होम सी अगेन समथिंग विच जस्ट केम विद प्रैक्टिस ओनली बट टेक्स टाइम अखिल ऑल्सो संदीप ऑल्सो हैज टू स्पीक सो जस्ट वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन बिफोर आई हैंड ओवर द माइक टू हिम Just one person. So one most important would be women empowerment for me. Second would be to work for persons with disabilities. These are my two main focus. And I would like to now hand over the mic to him. I hope you all enjoyed. If you have any more questions, you could just get in touch with me on my personal blog. I'll ask them to put the link somewhere. Okay, thank you.